All right, so as we start chapter 12, we will begin learning about the new nation and how it grew during the years 1815 through 1830. The War of 1812 brought a new mindset to how Americans viewed their role in the world picture, with newfound feelings of patriotism, loyalty, and devotion to their nation. These new feelings sometimes found conflict as the northern, southern, and western states matured and grew both in size and in culture. Section 1. Industries take root. The Industrial Revolution began in England in the middle of the 1700s as investors created new machines that revolutionized how products were made. The British were very protective of these inventions and limited the ability of people in specific industries to travel and leave the country. The textile industry was the first affected by innovation. Machines could now make thread, yarn, and cloth. Before thread, yarn, and cloth were made by machine, they were made in cottage industries, meaning they were mostly made in small cottages or shops, locally owned, locally provided, just within the community. With the invention of the spinning jenny, machines could now be housed in factories and were operated by large groups of workers. In the factory system, large amounts of goods could be produced faster and cheaper than in the cottage system. This led to larger profits and the urbanization of life. Many inventions contributed to the Industrial Revolution. In 1764, James Hargreaves invented the spinning jenny, a machine that would spin wool and cotton threads many at a time instead of one person doing one spindle at a time. Then, in 1769, Richard Arkwright created the water frame to improve the spinning jenny so that it could be powered by water and spin even more threads. This was followed by the creation of the steam-powered loom for weaving cotton in 1786 by Edmund Cartwright. One of the first Americans to invent a machine during this time period was Eli Whitney and his cotton gin that quickly and efficiently removed seeds from cotton. One cotton gin could do the work of 50 people by hand. This didn't mean the limit and elimination of slavery. This meant the need for even more slaves, as now machines could do the work that slaves previously did in picking seeds. That meant more slaves were needed in the fields planting and picking cotton so that the cotton gin could pick the seeds from the cotton and produce more thread, yarn, and cloth for an even growing population around the world. In 1796, James Watt and Oliver Evans improved the design of the steam engine so that it could power machines, allowing factories to move away from riversides and water pressure to inland areas and steam pressure. The Industrial Revolution came to the United States in the late 1700s. An Englishman escaped the control of the textile mills in England and brought his knowledge to America, where he offered his knowledge and services to Moses Brown, a wealthy Quaker who owned a poorly run cotton mill in Rhode Island. In Boston, Francis Cabot Lowell made further advances in the textile industry when he put the entire process of converting cotton into cloth in one building in Waltham, Massachusetts. Eli Whitney wasn't quite done inventing. This time he took on how guns were made and developed the system of interchangeable parts. This meant, as a part wore out or was lost, it could be replaced easily and cheaper than replacing the whole gun or machine. When this system of parts was placed into the factory system, it led to the development of another Industrial Revolution idea, the division of labor system, in which each worker did only one or two simple jobs instead of creating an entire product. One result of these developments was the mass production of products. Once again, more products, less time to create, more money to make. Many workers in the new factories were women and children. With their small, dextile fingers, they were able to do the work needed with these new machines used to create yarn, string, and fabric. To improve the working conditions and get higher wages, working people began to form labor unions. One result of the Industrial Revolution was the growth of cities, where the factories were located. In 1810, 90% of Americans lived on farms. New York City had a population of 96,000 and grew to over 203,000 by 1830. Philadelphia saw the same dramatic growth. During the same time period, Philadelphia saw a dramatic growth in population as well, going from 91,000 to 161,000 during the same 20-year period. Now it's time for the test review questions. Question number one. The Industrial Revolution sparked the growth of American factories and cities and created a need for A. a better transportation system, B. more slaves to work fields, C. new government regulations. Question number two. Which best describes the location of factories in New England during the early 1800s? A. close to rivers, B. in isolated areas, C. close to coal deposits, D. close to railways. Question number three. Explain how the invention of the cotton gin affected the demand for slave labor in the United States and changed the economic and social direction of the South.